A, B, C, D, E, F, G are seven friends from seven different cities, namely Ranchi, Mumbai, Delhi, Jaipur, Patna, Chennai, Kolkata, but not necessarily in the same order. Working in three departments of a company in production, HR, and marketing, with at least two in each department. And the following information is provided. All right, so we've got seven friends, A to G, seven cities, Ranchi, Mumbai, Delhi, Jaipur, Patna, Chennai, Kolkata, and three different departments, production, HR, and marketing. So these seven guys are working in these three departments with at least two in each department, right? So if you look at the distribution, there will be minimum two in each department. So two times three, six persons are distributed. There will be one department which will have three persons, right? So by the time you finish reading this statement, you must be clear in your head that two of the departments will have two persons each, and the third department or the third one will have three persons. All right. And following is the information given to us, right? Seven clues have been given to us. Like F is working in the HR department. The one who is from Mumbai is working in production with E. E is not from Delhi, and so on. Now, usually, how do we solve such questions? Like if you have gone through the videos, we have discussed that first list down the persons here, right? So maybe you try with that. See what happens. A, B, C, D, E, F, and G, right? Seven persons here. Now, on one side, we'll try to take the names of the cities, and the other side, we'll take the department, right? So let's say the department on the left-hand side and cities here on the right-hand side, okay? Look at the clues. F is working in the HR department. F works in the HR department, right? Remember, minimum two in each department. H is working in the HR department. F is working in the HR department. The one who is from Mumbai is working in production with E. Now, look at this point. The one who is from Mumbai is working in production with E. Now, who is from Mumbai is not known to us. But that guy from Mumbai works in the production department. With E means what? See, some two of these persons, if they're working together, means what? They're from the same department. Now, we know that the guy who's working in production works with E. So, can I now conclude that E is from production department? Yes or no? We don't know who is that person from Mumbai who's in production, but E is also in production with them, right? And E is not from Delhi. So that's one point given to us. The one who is from Delhi is working with B, but not with F. The one who is from Delhi is working with B, but not with F. Now, there are like a lot of indirect clues given to us. The one who is from Delhi is working with B. So can I conclude that B is not from Delhi? See, the guy from Delhi is working with B. So we can come to a conclusion that B is not from Delhi. And this guy who is working with B is not working with F, which means he's not working in HR department, because we already know that F works for HR department. So the one who's coming from Delhi is not working in HR department. And also B will not work for HR department. If B doesn't work for HR department, there are two possibilities, production or management. So I think with the kind of clues given to us, this method may not really help, right? G is working only with the one who is from Kolkata, but not in the HR department. So again, G is not from Kolkata, because G works with one of the persons who is from Kolkata. And there's only one person from Kolkata. So G is not from Kolkata, and they're not from HR department. So again, production or marketing. F is working with the one who is from Jaipur. So F is not from Jaipur. The person who is from Ranchi is neither F nor C. So a lot of negative statements have been given. I mean, instead of saying who is from Ranchi, he's saying who is not from Ranchi. Right? Or instead of saying F belongs to Jaipur, he's saying F does not belong to Ranchi. You're getting it? D is working only with the one who is from Patna. A is neither working with B nor with G. So I think this format will not really help. This format is not going to help. So what we'll try and do instead is, you know, do the grouping. I think grouping will work better in such cases. Let me do that, right? Let me just clear this out and help you with other method which should work better, right? So what we'll do is, instead of doing a linear assignment, we'll try to group them, right? We know that there are three groups. What are the three groups here? Production, HR, and marketing, right? So group number one is production, group number two is HR, and the third one is marketing. So what we'll now try and find out is who is from production, who is from HR, and who is from marketing, and which cities belong to production, HR, and marketing respectively. Look at this. The first point, F is working in HR department. So F comes in the HR department. All right. First point is used. F is working in HR department. There's nothing else left there. Second point, the one who is from Mumbai is working in production with E. So like we have discussed earlier, we now know that E is also working in production department, because the guy who's coming in from Mumbai is working in production along with E. So clearly E is also from production department. So I can say that he's from production department. And the guy from Mumbai is also in the production department. Read the statement here. The one who's from Mumbai is working in the production department with E. So he's in production department, and his friend who comes from Mumbai is also in production department. So I can say this one guy from Mumbai who's going to work along with E. Now, who is this guy is not known to us. We'll fill the gap later. Which city does E belong to? Again, we'll find out later. But clearly, E and Mumbai are belonging to the production department or belong to the production department. And E is not from Delhi. Keep this point in mind. E is not from Delhi. Right? E is not from Delhi. The one who is from Delhi is working with B, but not with F. The one who is from Delhi. The one who is from Delhi is working with B, but not with F. So understand, the one who's from Delhi is not working with F. So that guy will not come in the HR department. But the Delhi guy is working with B. The Delhi guy is working with B. Now there are two possibilities. There are two possibilities here. Understand, E is not from Delhi. We very clearly know that. The one who is from Delhi is working with B. Now where is B working? No clue. B could be working production or HR or marketing. But this Delhi guy works with B but not with F. So Delhi guy will not come in HR. Delhi guy will either come for production or marketing. These are the only two possibilities. If Delhi comes in production, we can conclude that B is from Mumbai, right? This guy will be B then, because Delhi works with B. So if Delhi comes here, let's say if Delhi you take here, then B will belong to Mumbai. Are you able to follow? I'm just writing the possibility here. Let me take a different color so that you're not confused. We clearly know that the one who is from Delhi is working with B but not with F. So Delhi cannot come in HR. Delhi may come here. Now you may also ask me that why can't we write Delhi for E? Very clearly it is given that E is not from Delhi. E is not from Delhi. So you cannot write Delhi for E. Delhi guy may come here. If Delhi guy comes here, what do we know? This person from Delhi is working with B. See, there can be maximum three persons in any given department. We have already got three slots here, right? E, Mumbai, Delhi. So definitely B has to be the person who is from Mumbai. This is one possibility. I'm not concluding that this is correct. The other possibility is that Delhi and B both belong to the marketing department. So you have to keep this in mind, right? I'll clear it out because we're not jumping to any conclusions without being very sure about it. But these are the two possibilities. Either Delhi and B both belong to production or Delhi and B belong to marketing, right? We'll come that to that point later. Look at the next statement. G is working only with the one who is from Kolkata. This keyword only is very, very important. See, G is working only with the one who is from Kolkata, but not in HR department. Again, G does not belong to HR department. G does not belong to HR department. G does not belong to HR department means what? G could belong to production or marketing. But if you see, G is working only with the one who is from Kolkata. So the department in which G works, there are only two persons. One is G and the other one who is from Kolkata. The department in which G works, there are only two persons in that department. One is G and the other one who is from Kolkata. And this is not the HR department. So what are the possibilities? If you see, one possibility is that G is from Mumbai and E is from Kolkata. So we can conclude that production department has got only two persons. Or again, G and Kolkata could belong to the marketing group. Are you able to follow? See, all these things, I mean, it is taking a little longer to explain, but when you do it yourself, you will verify all these possibilities in your head. G is working only with the one from Kolkata. So I can say G belongs to Mumbai and E is from Kolkata. So G is working only with the one who is from Kolkata, and both of them are in the production department. Or G is working with the guy from Kolkata in the marketing department. So clearly G and Kolkata would be in one group. And in the earlier case, in statement 2, we had verified that Delhi and B will be in the other group. Okay. Let us just see. Is there any other clue given to us which can help us complete it? F is working with the one who is from Jaipur. F is working with the one who is from Jaipur. F is working with someone who is from Jaipur. So F cannot belong to Jaipur, but the other guy in the HR department will be from Jaipur. Right? This statement is done. Next statement. The person who is from Ranchi is neither F nor C. The person who is from Ranchi is neither F nor C. Not really useful immediately, right? The person who is from Ranchi is neither F nor C cannot be used immediately. D is working only with the one who is from Patna. D is working only with the one who is from Patna. Now, this again is important, right? Look at the keyword only. D is working only with the one who is from Patna. D is working only with the one who is from Patna. So what are the possibilities again? It can be like this. D here from Mumbai, E from Patna. and production department has got 2 employees. D from Jaipur and F from Patna. So that way HR department has got only 2 employees. Or D and Patna can come here. Are you able to follow? Wherever D works, there'll be only 2 persons. One is D and the other guy who's from Patna. So all the 3 departments can take D and Patna now. D can be from Mumbai, E can be from Patna, D can be from Jaipur, F can be from Patna, or D and Patna guys are in marketing department. And last point here is A is neither working with B nor with G. A is neither working with B nor with G. Okay, so I think one reading is done. Now you'll have to do the second reading because those hidden points would come out. See, you have quickly read one time all the statements. You know that there are like pairs. G with Kolkata, right? B with Delhi and D with Patna. Now we'll just do the second reading and see. So the one who is from Mumbai is working in the production department with E. E is not from Delhi. The one who is from Delhi is working with B but not with F. G is working with only the person who is from Kolkata and not in HR department. F is working with the one who is from Jaipur. This is simple. The person who is from Ranchi is neither F nor C. This would be useful only later. D is working only with the one who is from Patna. A is neither working with B nor with G. A is neither working with B nor with G. So what could be the hidden point there? Try and think about that. Which point will help us understand about the pair? You understand there are 3 pairs that we have established. Delhi will go along with B, G will go along with Kolkata, and D will go along with Patna. Meaning not that B is from Delhi, but B is working with the person who is from Delhi. D is working only with the one who is from Patna. Okay, this point, I think, yeah. Now if you see, look at point number 6. Point number 6 should help us. D is working only with the one who is from Patna. This will help us. Point number 6. Focus on point number 6. D is working only with the one who is from Patna. The one who is from Mumbai is working in production with E. E is not from Delhi. The one who is from Delhi is working with B. G is working only with the one who is from Kolkata but not in HR department. So can we take G from Mumbai and E from Kolkata and close the production department? 2 possibilities. No, there also there are 2 possibilities. G is working only with the one who is from Kolkata but not in the HR department. What is the point that we are missing? F is working in HR. Done. The one who is from Mumbai is working in production with E. Is done. E is not from Delhi. Is done. The one who is from Delhi is working with B but not F. The one who is from Delhi is working with, yeah, so I think there are only 2 possibilities as such, but which one should we go with? Let me do one thing. Let me just take one of the cases and see what happens. The one who is from Delhi is working with B but not with F. I'm taking up this point now. The one who is from Delhi is working with B but not with F. So Delhi guy will not come in the HR department. Let us assume Delhi guy is from the production department. So the one who is working, the one who is from Delhi is working with B but not with F. We know that E is not from Delhi. Right? We know that E is not from Delhi. So Delhi cannot be taken here. Maybe there's a 3rd person here from Delhi. And the one who is working, from Delhi is working with B but not with F. He is working with B. This Delhi guy is working with B. So can we say that B belongs to Mumbai? Yeah. Now proceed, see what happens. I think this is one of the possibilities. I'm just trying to see what exactly happens if we proceed. So point number 2 has been used completely, right? Point 3 says G is working only with the one who is from Kolkata, but not in HR department. Now point 3 can be used. G is not working in the HR department. So G has to come. And again, G works with a person. G works with only 1 person. So G cannot come in production because in production we have got 3 persons. G is not from HR. So G has to be in the marketing department. And G works with the one who is from Kolkata. So Kolkata comes here. Right? Shall we take the other possibility also? Let me just see what happens. Again, I don't want to start from scratch. Just give me a minute. What I'll do is, I'll take the other possibility here. Because why is that we are getting 2 cases? You know, right? Whenever we have 2 possibilities, we better consider both of them and towards the end, eliminate the one which you think is wrong. So this is case 1, let's say. And here I'm taking case 2. Okay. First of all, remember, I'll clear this B and Delhi here because this only gave us 2 cases, right? I'll copy exactly what we have done so far. E, this Mumbai. HR may we have F and the guy from Jaipur, and marketing may we have got G and the guy from Kolkata. Okay, case 2. Now look at this point, right? The one who is from Delhi is working with B but not with F. So Delhi guy will not come in the HR department because F is in the HR department, but Delhi can come in production or marketing. So let us take Delhi in production. So Delhi here in production, Delhi works with B. So B will be from Mumbai. Or the other possibilities, G Kolkata also we have just done. Sorry, I'll clear G Kolkata also because marketing was not filled until then. This is a later point that we have added. And the other possibility is that Delhi and B will come in the marketing department. So we can say B is in marketing and the guy from Delhi is in the marketing department. Are you able to follow? I've considered both the cases. Delhi and B can belong to production or marketing. Now we are very sure that one of these two will be correct, right? Let's not be in any dilemma. The next point that we had used was point number three. G is working only with the one who is from Kolkata, but not in HR department. So G works with the Kolkata guy, but not in HR department. So G and Kolkata will not come in HR, either production or marketing. So again, there are two possibilities. G is working only with the one who's from Kolkata. So I can say G is from Mumbai, E is from Kolkata, or G is from Delhi and B is from Kolkata. Here production is rooted. Okay, if you look at case one, according to case one, when you say G and Kolkata are the only two guys working in one of the departments, G and Kolkata would not come in production because in production we have got three persons. G, we know, does not work in HR. So G and Kolkata would come for marketing. G works with the guy from Kolkata. But in case two, again, I'm getting two possibilities. G from Mumbai, E from Kolkata, or G from Delhi and E from B from Kolkata. Let me see what happens. Next statement says F is working with the one who's from Jaipur. This is done. The person who's from Ranchi is neither F nor C. No. Achha, look at this point number six. Let us now use point number six. D is working only with the one who's from Patna. D is working only with the one who's from Patna. D is working only with the one who's from Patna. So D either comes in HR or marketing. D is working only with the one who is from Patna. Even in case one, there are multiple possibilities. D is working only with the one who is from Patna. So I can say D is in Jaipur, F is from Patna, or D is from Kolkata, G is from Patna. I think there are too many possibilities. I don't see there is a single solution for this one, right? Or maybe we'll have to consider all of them. Last point says A is neither working B nor with G. Okay, I think with respect to case 1, case 2 is still pending, but in case 1, if I try to apply point number 7, it says A is neither working with B nor with G. So it does not work with B, A does not work with G. So the only place where A works is HR. The only possibility is HR department. Yeah. And if I use this point number 5, the person who is from Ranchi is neither F nor C. So the person who is from Ranchi is neither F nor C. How many cities are left out? 3 cities are left out. Yeah. So Ranchi is neither F nor C. Ranchi can be G or E. Yeah. So tell me guys, what have you done? I think many of you said we have got it. Yeah. Now if you use point number 6, I'm only considering case 1 because case 2 has got still multiple possibilities. D is working only with the one who is from Patna. D is working only with the one who is from Patna. So clearly D would be from Kolkata because the department in which D works, there have to be only two persons. So production is ruled out. D is working only with the one who is from Patna. So HR also is ruled out because already F and A are there. The only place where a person can be accommodated is marketing. So D works in the marketing department. And G is from Patna, right? So this is done. Then again, last point, the fourth point says F is working for the one who is from Jaipur. Yeah. This fifth point says the person who is from Ranchi is neither F nor C. So see, F is not from Ranchi. If F is not from Ranchi, clearly E is from Ranchi because there is no other choice we have, right? Now only one person is left out, right? A, B, D, E, F, G are done. So C is left out. C comes from Delhi and only one city is left out. Which is that city? Patna, Kolkata, Jaipur, Ranchi, Mumbai, Delhi and which city is that? Chennai. F is from Chennai, right? F is from Chennai. So this is one of the possible cases in my view. Production department has got E, B and C who belong to Ranchi, Mumbai, Delhi respectively. HR department has got F and A who belong to Chennai and Jaipur respectively. And the marketing department has got G and D who belong to Patna and Kolkata. Right? All of you have got the same answer. But I would still say that this is with one assumption that Delhi and B are from the production department. The other possibilities are there. Where will the second possibility fail? I'm just wondering, where will case 2 fail? Anyway, I'm sure all of you have got the same result, right? Like what we have got in case 1. So try out the other case also. Let's not waste our time here we'll move to the next question now. But what I want all of you to do is try case 2 now. We have done only 3 steps here. E in Mumbai production, F in Jaipur in HR, B in Delhi in marketing. Now try to, you know, fill the gaps and see if you are actually getting stuck somewhere so that we can rule the case 2 out. Or if you can complete case 2 as well. Right? Shall we go for the next one now? I don't think questions have been asked along with this. Questions have been asked? No, questions have not been asked. So shall we go for the next one now? Selvaraj has also already confirmed that case 2 is not coming. Somewhere case 2 fails. Saurabh Singh says, I did not consider case 2 at all. I just solved using case 1. So Saurabh, I would say you are lucky that case 1 came to a proper structure. If case 1 fails somewhere, then you'll have to start from the scratch. So that is the reason, always consider the possibilities from the point where it arises. You getting me? I mean, that's what I was also trying to do initially, right? Consider only case 1 and complete. But there's a risk. If case 1 fails, you'll have to start from the scratch, which we should never do. Okay, so give it a try. See case 2 what happens. I'm sure there'll be case 3 also when you start working on case 2. So consider all those possibilities and, you know, hopefully 2 and 3 should get eliminated somewhere. Sagar Singh has asked a question. Do we need to do this in the preliminary examination or skip? Now, Sagar, I'm sure it must be clear by now that you better skip such questions, because see, if you are comfortable considering only one of the cases and going ahead with it, try it out. Have to be lucky to get the answer in the first attempt. Otherwise, skip. First, solve the easier ones and then come back to such questions. See, Namrata has mentioned that she has got a different answer, right? I've got a different one. So Namrata, if you can verify all the statements once again and check if all the statements are satisfied in the grouping that you have got, then we can conclude that there are 2 solutions for this question. Right? Like Aditya also says that I am getting C in marketing and D in production. So looks like Aditya has got a different answer. And that's what I was worried about, right? There could be 2 possible answers for this one. Yeah, Namrata has confirmed that she has verified 3 times and it satisfies all the conditions. So guys, like I mentioned, there are 2 solutions for the previous one, or multiple solutions for the previous question. Please be careful. So Sandeep, who had posted that one, has to check the source once again, right? Mamta also says that I too got a different answer, which satisfies all the conditions. All right.